see Tupac. Call the cops when you see Tupac. Who shot me? But your pumps didn't finish. Now you're about to feel the wrath of a menace. Nigga, I hit him up. Check this out. You motherfuckers know what time it is. I don't even know why I'm on this track. Y'all niggas ain't even on my level. I'ma let my little homies ride on you.
Get out the way, yo, get out the way, yo. Biggie Smalls just got dropped. Little move past the mat and let me hit him in his back. Frank Wright need to get spanked right for setting traps. Little accident murderers, and I ain't never heard of ya. Poisonous cats attack when I'm serving ya. Spank and shake your whole style when I gank. Guard your rank, cause I'ma slam your ass in the paint. Puffy weaker than the fucking block I'm running through, nigga. And I smoke a Junior Mafia in front of you, nigga. With the ready power, tucking my gas under my Eddie Bauer. Your clown petty sour, I'll put packages every hour. Hit him up.
Grab your blocks when you see Tupac. Call the cops when you see Tupac. You shot me, but your punch didn't finish. Now you're about to feel the wrath of a menace. Nigga, we hit him up. We thought we knew it. Keep it real, it's penitentiary steel. This ain't no freestyle battle. All you niggas getting killed with your mouths open. Trying to come up over me, you in the clouds open. Smoking dope, it's like a Sherman.
I know these things ain't right. But you was blowing up her phone last night. But she ain't have a ring or not her ring on last night. Ooh, that's that nerve. Why give a bitch your heart when she rather have a purse? Why give a bitch inch when she rather have nine? You know how the game goes, she be mine by halftime. Ooh, that's that nerve. You all about her and she all about hers. Birdman Jr. and his no flamingos. And I done did every day but trust these seats.
DJ Miss Fridah. DJ Miss Fridah? I'm a miss. I'm not a missus. I was born and bred in Mombasa. Okay, but yeah, that's where I started my DJing journey. I was actually the first female DJ in the whole of Coast Province. I was passionate for it. That's one thing I'll tell you. I love music, I'm good with my music, and the biggest support that I got is from my family. That's one thing I can tell you. When they ask mom, I wanna do this, she told me do it. But you know the Costarian people, the way they talk, like, do it like, you know, sinibwa? Usinibwage, elewa? So I had to work so hard to be the best. 2008, 2009, I got 2 awards for the best DJ of the year, 2008 and 2009. Not female in that category, the rest were just dudes. Because Kenya Coastal Music Awards, 2008, 2009. One funny thing is, I want to answer this question in a stupid way. The funny thing is, me didn't get it the easy way. I really didn't take the lift. I did with my DJing life. I got it. I had to take the stairs. So I didn't have this thing that I'm a female DJ. I had this thing that I am a DJ and I have to play music and I have to play music the way it's supposed to be played. So when you tell me, like, what's the catch? First of all, I was the first female DJ in Mombasa. You know, I've been a DJ for a very long time. Huh? Like, it's almost 8 to 9 years right now. Guys were in shock. So I didn't see it. I didn't see the catch. I really didn't see the catch. But when I went to Bella Vista, I'd tell you, I'd pull more crowd, a bigger crowd, because I was a female. I think I sold that club because there was a female DJ playing in that club. But I really cannot point out any catch. I can't. Yes, I cannot answer that question generally because everyone, even the other female DJs, kina Piera, kina Unique, kila mtu ana story yake. But you know, for me, mine is very, very different because they had to make me look, you know, I was being told, the person who trained me told me, When somebody is drinking, having his drink in a club and you're playing music, the mentality I want that person to have is, it's a dude playing music. Because people believe that women cannot do it properly like the way the men do it, you know. They cannot have the flow, they cannot do the scratches, they cannot beat match, you know. That's what my trainer told me. But when the guy turns and see a female DJ, that's how you're gonna be appreciated. So that's the motto I've been going with since then. For me, I had to work so hard. Nobody babied me. You know, like, they were like, Frida, you have to do it. You have to. It's like they saw that this chick is gonna be our ambassador, you know. Like, this chick will go places. So it wasn't easy. I got so underpaid. I was really conned. Okay, people really took advantage of me because I'm a chick. They just think, you know, I'll just buy her drinks, flirt with her, she'll play music for us, and I won't pay her. No. So, but then that's when I decided to start boxing and everything, you know, so that these promoters, they won't mess around with me. And you know, the first two, three years when I started DJing, I never even used to dress like a chick. No, I started dressing like a chick when I came to Nairobi. But when I was in Kostobi, I used to put on Gina's t-shirt and sneakers. Because you know, if you mess around with me, I'm just gonna hit you very, very hard. See, so underpayment and the flirting thing. No, it really took time. Okay, I started training at Bob's Bar. In 2003. In 2004, I was working in Florida. Like, literally, that's where I got a job. Bob's, angeza kunikubali kwa sababu tayari, ma DJ walikuwa. They had very good DJs. Na walikuwa na DJ moja dem by the way anaitwa Winnie. Even that chick is one of the chicks who pushed me. Uyo dem alikuwa anaangusha soul si mchezo. Na anazijua. Wacha mimi nilikuja kuchezea soul Nairobi, you know. So 2004 was in Florida. 2005 kidogo nilikuwa na tashwishi ya kazi, but I worked in Florida for 1 year. So 2005 nika decide to step out kwa sababu seriously me, I don't stand dudes who just act like women and I'm the one with a chick, I'm supposed to act like that. So I decided to pull out from that job and start like looking for other jobs. 2006, I think that's when I met you. I came for the way out, right? Yeah, Tusker Project Fame. That's when I started venturing Nairobi. That's when I met Kevin Ombajo. That's when I worked with guys of True Black, Kina More, Kina Eric. 2007, I was doing campaigns. You see, I've not been stable in one place. 2007, I was doing campaigns. I got a job with Zinduka. So we had to go around the whole of Kenya to do civil education. 2008, okay, but then when I finished with the campaigns, that's when I joined I went to Bella Vista. I had the auditions. So by the time it was 2008, I was already blowing up because now I'm at a central place. You know, like you can go there and find this chick. And I loved that place. I was committed to that. That's a very interesting story to tell. You know, I blew up so much in Mombasa. Okay, the clubs were less. And there was no competition. And then it went to an extent, even guys could not even pay me in Mombasa. You get? So I decided to join the bigger market. And I really thought it was gonna be a very big opening for me, but I just had to, cause if I was to stay at home, I'd be wasting a lot of talent. And when I was in Mombasa, I worked with a lot of people, and they knew this chick exists. But you know, the moment like, you pull out of Jobo and you start doing other things, you're wasting resources. So I decided to make the big move and move into Nairobi. You know, one thing I'm always proud about that story is I didn't ask for the job. The unit came to me. Okay, with DJ units, I'd say it's a good platform for advertising yourself, for making your name and everything, because they will do, at the end of the day, you're a brand ambassador, and that's the good thing about the unit. They will make your name grow. Just like Code Red, we can talk about K-Trix, Mr. T, Creme de la Creme. They were all in one unit, and they decided to pull out, and they made it because the unit made them, you get. That is what I can say. That's the good thing about a unit. Another thing is growing your skills. I've learned something from Nijo, you know. I learned, with the skill, because, you know, you have to pull up your socks. You have to be, like, the same level. So if you cannot reach that level, you knew your boss, eh? Sindio, we're gonna jump domain. We'll just tell you off, and you know, even and I came to discover even styles was the same, and in fact at least I'd say space was a little bit polite and say it, you know, but you know, I was told Alan is damn loud. And everyone will listen to it. So you have to like be in the same level. So with the skills and the and making your name and the advertisement and everything, the units, that is okay. Micromanagement. Minta wambia kwa Kiswahili, si siri. Kuna kupendeleana sana. Kuna wale wanasikizwa, kuna wale wasikizwi. Kuna kuto kulipwa, kuna wengine walipwa, wengine walipwi. That's under kupendeleana, unajua. And then there's also overworking. Overworking, you'll be overworked and underpaid. And maybe sometimes you won't be paid. Tusemo kweli. Mgala muwe haki yake mpe. Situongea jo unit, kwani mfano si unit. Mfano si ni unit. Sheriffs walikuwa unit. This is the best place for with the passion I have and entertainment and how things are done with the clubs and everything. When I came to Nairobi, my workstation was Galileo. I'd never entered a club like Galileo. My boss, the first thing he didn't even get me inside with the main. He took me to the VIP direct. Me, I was in shock. I think in the first 2-3 months, I was not talking. I was very humble. Yeah? I just go to the office, Galileo. Go to the office with people think outside the box. With entertainment, Nairobi, you can grow. You'll see things that you've never seen. I had never seen a club like Galileo. I nilikuja kukalia makochi kwa club Nairobi bana. Mombasa kulikuwa hakuna sofas bana. That's I didn't know. And then when I came to Nairobi, that's when I opened up. I started getting gigs outside Kenya. You see. Kwa hivyo, hino ndio headquarters ya kila kitu sasa. Mambo yote yani, huku ndo kusema.